Greetings, this is LGR here, being somewhat lazy and just enjoying my collection. And if you've noticed on my Twitter and stuff, I've been going through a lot of my boxed games recently, just sort of reorganizing and building some sweet shelves and stuff for them. And, I started thinking about the topic of, like, what the heck is my favorite box art? You know, like big box PC games and stuff. And, I'm not talking about the whole package. I'm not talking about, like, shapes or, like, stuff on the back or the side. I'm just talking about, like, the cover art specifically for old school PC game boxes. And there's a lot out there that I adore. And I started realizing that my absolute favorites, I end up sticking on, like, you know, right over there. So why don't I just take what's right over there and show you, at least in this one video here, and then maybe we'll expand to others if this goes over well. But, yeah, look, I'm just going to take a look at these in no particular order, and once again, this is not all-encompassing, this is just some of my absolute favorites overall. And we're going to start here with the first wizardry, the Proving Grounds of the Mad Overlord. And this is not only an awesome game, but the box is just, it's super cool. I think this texture is just sort of like a faux leather thing going on is awesome. And then there's this green dragon that's just, it's shiny. And against the black backdrop, it is just fantastic. And of course, that awesome wizardry logo, the Surtek logo. This is just a box that I wanted for a long time. And then when I finally got it, just instantly became one of my favorites because it's even better in person. Now here I've got one that I really just sought out strictly because of the box art, and this is Transarctica, also known as Arctic Baron, and this is a Silmarils game, and if you know anything about their stuff, then, well, sometimes their games can be a little obtuse, but yeah, I really just friggin' love this artwork. I mean, this thing looks just so metal, and if you don't notice the scale of this giant evil train, there's these little people down there and stuff, and this thing is just super cool looking, even though it's not the most representative of the game itself, and there's a reason for that. It's actually based on a Rodney Matthews ink painting called Heavy Metal Hero, and it had already been used for the cover of the album Am I Evil for the band Diamond Head, but yeah, they just thought it was so friggin' sweet that they repurposed it for Transarctica, and man, I can see why, because this is awesome. Here's another one that I sought out mainly because of the box art, and this is Terror Pods by Psygnosis. And yes, this is indeed another one of the Roger Dean covers, or at least it's more or less that. It's actually an adaptation of a Roger Dean piece. This is actually done by Tim White. But yeah, Roger Dean, he was the guy that also did, like, the, of course, the Psygnosis logo, but a whole lot of stuff. Like concept art for sci-fi and fantasy, and also a lot of prog rock album art for bands like Asia and whatnot. This was originally from a series of illustrations for Omni Magazine's version of H.G. Wells' War of the Worlds in 1985, and yes, again, it was repurposed for the purposes of this purpose, which is purposely sweet. Here's one that may be a little bit of an odd choice for some. This is Commander Heen, Alien Ate My Babysitter. Some might say that this is just a little odd, like, Keen's head is weirdly small. I mean, yeah, sure, he's a kid, but it still looks just weird, and everything about it is just kind of weird, and like a strange airbrush thing you'd find on the street corner. But, you know, I like that, and I can't figure out who exactly did this. There's no listing of the artist in the credits, but yeah, it just has a bizarre and strange otherworldly look, and for me, that actually makes a lot of sense for Commander Keen, and I just think it's kind of cool. This right here is an absolute classic that really needs no introduction, but we're going to do it anyway. This is The Secret of Monkey Island. And of all the LucasArts covers, I mean, I could have picked tons of them. I love the Dig cover, I love the Sam & Max cover, and, you know, whatever. But this one right here, it's just always been an absolute favorite of mine, and this one is illustrated by Steve Purcell, just the all-around LucasArts dude. He has done a ton of work for them, and this is one of his most well-known, especially this piece right here, which I've been meaning to get this, like, blown up into a poster or something, because I seriously just love that. And another bit of awesome. Oh, I love this box. And the artwork, this is the Elder Scrolls Chapter 2, Daggerfall. This particular cover was illustrated by Luis Sandoval, who also did the artwork for Battlespire and Carandia games and the Eye of the Beholder series and a bunch of other things. But yeah, this is one of my absolute favorites, not only because of this insanely cool design, this just evil king thing and all this whatnot going on the front, but the fact that it's a hollow foil box. So it's not embossed, but it looks like it's embossed. It has a 3D effect because of the hollow graphic foil underneath it. It just looks so cool. And yeah, there's the European version of this as well, which does not have that going on. And it's still just really cool, creepy artwork that's all like dark and fantasy ridden. And I love that. So yeah, it's good either way. But this holofoil just takes it to the next level. Yes. More role-playing goodness. This right here is Wasteland, Adventure in Post-Nuclear America, the predecessor to the Fallout games. And just, I love this game. I even love its sequel, which uses some insanely similar cover art. And this one right here is by Barry Jackson, who also did the cover art for Project Firestart, and I'm sure he did some other stuff, but those are the two that I mainly know him for. And this, it just, it's awesome because, I don't know, the angle itself is rather striking. It's from way up above, like how you would be seeing in the game. You have this classic situation of being totally outnumbered and presumably outgunned in this horrible looking place. It's practically monochromatic and everything with the colors, and it's just, it's striking. And combined with the fonts and everything else, just, it draws you in right to the middle of this thing before you even get into the game. You're drawn straight to the center, and that is a good cover. Here's another one I am strangely just drawn to, and that is The Dagger of Amun-Ra. This is the second Laura Bow game from Sierra, and there's, again, like LucasArts, there's a bunch of covers of theirs that I could easily pick, but this one here that is put together by John Gamash, who also did the King's Quest V and Inca covers. It has this embossed gold thing going on here, and being with the Egyptian theme and everything that it has going on, that's just really super classy. And this is one of those that there's more going on to it than at first glance. I mean, sure, you see Laura Bow inspecting and doing stuff like that, but then you notice the guy over there that's about to strangle her with a rope, and yeah, it just really sets up the tone of the game where you can very much screw up and die like that, and it's awesome. And then you have a giant pharaoh head in the background and little cool Egyptian thingies on the desk and whatnot. And I just love Egyptian-themed stuff. So this, as a result, is one of my favorites. Coming up here, we have a couple that are kind of similar in theme. And this is the original Doom artwork. And yes, I'm showing the shareware version here because the box is a little larger. I have the full version release as well. But yeah, this illustration is such a classic. It's by Don Ivan Punchatz. I'm not sure if I'm saying his name right, but yeah, this guy is just legendary for his sci-fi and fantasy artwork, and a bit like Roger Dean, but he did this kind of stuff here that is just super metal. I don't know how else to describe it. It's like hell and demons and awesome stuff like this. He worked on artwork for Heavy Metal and Playboy and a bunch of other things. And yeah, sadly he has passed on, but he made some insanely cool artwork like this right here. And this is just absolutely one of the very best in PC game boxes. Yes, Doom 2 is really, really up there as well. I almost chose that one because really that's the one I remember seeing in stores anyway. I never really saw Doom 1 in stores at all. It makes sense because it was mail order. But yeah, this one, I just love the stuff that's going on here. And the fact that it almost kind of doesn't make sense with the game too. There's like another guy back in the back there. I mean, who is that? You're alone for the entire game. And again, I guess maybe because of the fact that it is just a little weird and stuff like that. It's awesome. And oh, how in the world can you say no to that original logo? That is some stellar logo design. Holy nuts. Here's another timeless classic, and also kind of similar in theme as far as man dude being up above his foes and shooting the crap out of them and whatnot. This is Duke Nukem 3D. My favorite DOS game, probably my favorite PC game, if not my favorite game of all time, period. And yeah, the box, oh, I remember the first time I saw this in a software, etc. store, and I was just absolutely floored because I was used to the look and vibe of Duke Nukem 1 and 2, and this was just such a wonderful departure from that. And, you know, as a boy just hitting puberty, I was just like, oh yeah, yeah, I gotta have this. This right here is designed by Robert Grace, who also eventually did like CG artwork for Riven and Uru, Ages Beyond Mist, and some other stuff, I'm sure, but this is his best work as far as what I've seen anyway. I love this. And of course, it is obviously inspired by the Army of Darkness poster, which that only makes sense considering how many lines Duke Nukem stole from Bruce Campbell's character. But whatever. This is a sort of a reference parody kind of game, and it makes sense that it would extend to the artwork. And just a couple more, at least for this particular episode. This right here is Monolith's Blood, and it just has unbelievably awesome artwork, period. I mean, and not just this original here with, you know, the sort of life-sized bloody handprint going on. That's all nicely embossed, and it's really just two colors, and I like the minimalist thing going on, similar to, like, Wizardry and such. But, you know, the shareware version also had a really cool thing going on, too. It was just a little bit of blood, as opposed to a whole, you know, mass of it over there, which made sense because this was just a little bit of the blood game as opposed to all the episodes. So there's a little bit of symbolism there going on with the cover. And also the plasma pack, I have to mention, because, well, really, it's the same kind of thing going on with the two-color duality thing going on. And it also just has this sweet silver shiny box. And as you might have guessed by now, it just likes shiny boxes. It's shiny and lovely and bloody and I just dig this so much. And lastly, another one of my absolute all-time favorite games and one of my favorite box arts ever. This is Out of This World by Eric Shahi, and also known as Another World, of course, but oh man, and this is such a cool friggin' piece, and I actually have it blown up on my wall. I hate the fact that they stuck these stupid stickers on the front of this particular box. I'm still actually looking for this box without the stickers because I love that art. It's creepy. It's like isolated. It has this imminent danger down at the bottom with your alien friend about, you know, just like picking up a rock about to attack that black liony monster thing from the first level and stuff. And it's just otherworldly, which is appropriate. Now, of course, I've also got to mention this. This is the alternate artwork, which is awful. It is like the polar opposite as far as quality. This is garbage. What did they do? Not only does this not look like your character at all in the game, it doesn't even resemble it. One of these like generic tentacle things. I mean, I know they're supposed to be like the tentacles at the beginning, and that's sort of a design of it's just like, it's so off. And it's so stupid. This could easily go in my worst box art list, as opposed to, you know, its sibling here, which is one of the absolute best. It's just crazy that they could get it so wrong within like a year of the initial release. Yeah, so maybe this will have to go into another video as far as like worst box art. But yeah, that is it for my initial video here on my favorite big box PC game arts. And I absolutely could have mentioned another 100 boxes because I've got thousands of them. But you get the point. Box art, especially the old school variety, is fantastic when it's done right. And these are just some of my favorites. Why not list yours in the comments? I'd love to see them. Chances are there's tons of them that I'm not even aware of. And if you would like more on similar topics, then this right here, LGR, is the channel for you. I like doing random videos like this on occasion, and I definitely have plans to do a lot more, as well as your regular reviews and tech tales and thrifting and whatever else is going to be coming up in the future. Subscribing would be beneficial if you like this kind of stuff. And you can also follow and interact with me on Twitter and Facebook if you'd like intermittent updates in between videos. That's a great place to do that. And you can also support the show on Patreon, which lets you see videos like this before anywhere else and gets you some extra perks as well as helping the show continue financially. And as always, thank you very much for watching.